Well, you did try to speak to him, right? You did try to speak to him.
I'm trying to speak to you now, though.
Well, boy, you've spoken to me. I've heard you, right? My action is this, yo. I'm going to just let my community know I'm going to be doing a video tomorrow. That's all. Hold on. He's been slandering, yeah? Saracen, my Sunni Ashari brethren, yeah? He's been slandering, yeah? My Shia brothers, yeah? He's been slandering, yeah? One of their teachers, or should I say Saracen teacher, one of my teachers who I like, yeah? Is Mufti Abu Layth, yeah? He's been doing all of this, yeah? And he's been slandering myself. Right?
Why don't you just speak to him in person instead of just back and forth?
What I just do?
I get it.
You see me, yeah? Sometimes I think I'm the biggest man here, yeah?
I get it.
My name will be talking the most crap about me. And I'm like, yo, let me smile. Let me come over and be like, yo, what's good, Jeep? You know, you're saying this and that about me. Let's talk about it. But instead of doing conflict resolution, yeah, where there is an issue, they do conflict avoidance. Calam, you're this, and let me run away. So the next man don't have a chance to say, yo, fam, what's up with that? He's been saying, Calam, you said, Muhammad is a pedo. And I pulled him up. I said, hold on, where did I say that? Okay, no, you didn't say that, but the collective of sorrow and you, I said, fam, where did I say it? Stop giving me, like, the first conversation or debate / discussion me and him had, yeah, was him coming over to me and talking to me about things that Sarah said. I'm like, fam, I'm not Sarah, G. Like, if you want to talk to me about what I've said, rather than what Sarah said. Most of these, like, Jahil Muslims, yeah, or should I say ignorant Muslims, yeah, most of them, yeah, they're upset with me for no reason at all. They can't even tell you why they're upset with me. They'll be calling me snake. Alright, why am I a snake? You know, we have to actually ask them, like, what have I done that snakeish? I just heard everybody else calling you it, so I'm just joining in. I hate you because I don't know why, I'm just hating on you. So, yo, let me confront you, G.
But that's a conversation you can have off camera and not all this back and forth. I'm making a video,
so,
you make a video.
So you know what? I tried to have the conversation.
But
you saw me. No. I done it for 2 weeks. 2 weeks prior to this, yeah? Wait, 2 weeks prior to this, yeah?
Hold on.
No. 2 weeks prior to this, he dropped videos, yeah? Upon Saracen, myself, and the Shears, yeah? I'm like, I'm standing right next to him. Why is he having discussions right next to him? To see what he's got to say. Look, nothing. Okay, cool. The following week, videos again. I stand right next to him. See what he's got to say. Nothing. Okay, yesterday he dropped a video. I was so pissed I wasn't able to respond. Even me, I was feeling a bit sick. Like, I got home, I said, yo! It's time for me to tear that ass up. The only way is that I got home, yeah? But the way I was feeling so ill, yeah, I couldn't even do it, yeah? So I said, all right, you know what? Let me bun the childish off. Let me just meet him at Speaker's Corner and see what he's going to say. Yo, Hussein, what's this video about? You saw the conversation, right? Who was practicing conflict resolution and who was practicing conflict avoidance?
Can you make your...
And then insulting me in it.
Are you...
And then insulting me. Come on, G.
So if in your head you're decided you're going to make this video regardless,
yeah.
Are you going to make it one that is like conflict resolution without the antagonistic words and all that? Are you going to try to like make that video an olive branch, like, yo, know, this and that was said, I'm still ready and willing to talk to you about these issues?
Okay. Now, see, I'm even giving away some of the secrets right now, yeah? What I was going to do, yeah, is all the nonsense he was saying, yeah, I'm quickly just hit him out of the park, like, bang, 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 all of it. And I'm going to make him look foolish on it as well, yeah? Hey, yo, don't come up behind me like that, my G. Quickly, shout him out.
Shout
no, you can't do that behind me, G. Are you mad? I'm ready to just, you know?
I'm ready to smoke,
trust me, heavy. That's on edge. All right, cool. So I'm just going to hit up, rebuttal all of himself, yeah? And then afterwards, I'm going to be doing this, yeah? You wanted to challenge Mufti Abu Layth. Let me challenge some of your teachers right now. And I was going to just challenge some of his teachers.
But that's the antagonist.
No. And I'm saying, I'm not challenging him. Like, Hussein here is not on my level to be challenging. Like, come on.
Why say that?
No, but it's the truth though. I'm only going to speak here with people of knowledge, students of knowledge. Hussein is a person here who's all he's done so far is slander, insult. You've seen him on camera. like he's there, like wanting to fight with you and stuff like that.
I didn't see that right now.
You ain't seen it. No, I'm saying like on previous videos.
That's previous.
On previous videos, yeah? So there's no point of me in having a discussion. I've got to be responsible, yeah? Not for myself, I'm easy. I've got to be responsible for him because right now he's a minor, yeah? No. I apologize. Let me take back the word minor. He's just not responsible enough. He's not responsible. The same way he's saying coon, house sneakers, and all these things here on his channel. And then he's got like Asians and Arabs, yeah, all saying, yeah, Callum's a coon and all these things here. They're being racist, right?
Yeah.
And then he's tagged along with it, like, yeah, happy. Bruv, I'm saying you're not a responsible individual, bro. If somebody now comes to you, yeah, and calls you an N-word, yeah, like on my channel even, bruv, yeah? You think I'm gonna be saying, yeah, my brother's an... I'm not gonna do that, bruv. That's some madness, bruv. So he's not responsible enough. I've got to think about him and his children. Because if I get into a conversation with him or debate with him, he can't handle himself and he can't handle losing. You see what I'm saying? He will literally lose his marbles and they wanna fight. And then it won't happen. He must probably end up in prison or something. His children is gonna be without a daddy for a little while. He's already been in and out of prison. Like, what am I gonna... No. Stop. Stop. No, I'm saying to you, I know his nature. So if he's been in and out of prison already, yeah? Why would I want to put him into a position where he will end back into prison? I'm not gonna do... Hold on, stop. Stop, no. His nature hasn't changed, okay? So why would I, yeah, want to put him into a position that he cannot handle? God doesn't do that, G. God doesn't give you things that you cannot handle. So you know what's going to do best for you? I'm going to get a champion for you. I'm going to call out a couple of your teachers, right? Yeah, and let them have the discussion that you're incapable of having with me.
And it's like wrestling.
That's just easy. That's just easy that way.
And it's like wrestling, man.
Boy,
WWE team.
It is what it is, G. Like I know, I fully well know that Hussein, that he can't have a conversation with me. There's a lot of people in here, yeah, that fully well know, yeah, they cannot have a conversation with me. The best they can do is insult me and call me names and walk away. That's the best they can do. And what the wickedest thing is, yeah, I don't insult anybody else, you know. I don't call anybody else names, you know. I don't try to fight anybody else, you know. All I simply do is ask people questions. And because I ask questions, I am now the enemy of them. I'm the enemy of their religion. But asking questions. Can you imagine?
That's crazy.
And then I present my research and I show you the sources. I'm like, yo, this is what my research says. This is what my sources says. This is not coming out of my mouth. Me, I don't talk about my mouth. Every single thing I say, yeah, I source. But they're upset with that. And they want to fight me for that. And they want to threaten my life for that. Come on. I can't have a conversation with Hussein in terms of a dialogue or discussion, in terms of debate, to learn something. I can't. Like, I go into debates and discussions with people I can learn something from. I can't learn nothing from him. What am I going to learn from him?
What can I learn from him?
I've already seen you. He hasn't got anything to offer.
Nah, man. I feel like
100%.
You can learn something from everybody.
Yeah, how not to be.
Yeah,
how not to be. I've learned how not to be.
Yeah.
So that's why I make sure I try my very best not to be like Hussein.
And you can learn how you guys can conversate with each other and
No. Hussein is suffering here from an identity crisis. So,
listen.
It's not even personal slander. See what I mean? Yeah? Everything I say, I back up. You with me? So it's not slander as long as I can back it up.
This my guy from way back, so I know his nature.
Okay, so can I explain? Yeah? As black people, we're all suffering from identity crisis, right? Those of us, when I say black people, I'm talking about descendants of enslaved Africans. We've been taken away from our natural habitat, right? We've been taken away from our heritage, we've been taken away from our names, our language, and so forth. We've lost all of that, most of us, yeah? And what do? We try to compensate for finding ourselves again, right? We try to find ourselves. Unfortunately, my brother, yeah, has gone into Islam to pick up himself. Not as a religion. Most people who convert, like white people, Asians, or Arabs, whatever type of people, they don't convert because of them having an identity crisis. They convert, yeah, to a religion. He's converted to a culture. You with me? That's why you see him wearing certain things, rolled up.
Have you had that conversation or is that your observations?
My observations and listening to him speak and confessing himself. So I already acknowledge, yeah, what state he's in. He's a black person that's suffering. That's why I go easy on him. When all the madness happened before, yeah, even my brothers, yeah, my Muslim brothers, like, no, raw. I see you, you know, you're a bit biased there, yeah. You didn't go in on Hussein. You got a little soft spot for Hussein. I said, yeah, I do have a soft spot for Hussein. He's a black brother. I realize he's suffering, so I'm not gonna go in on him like that. You see what I'm saying? When the whole Abdul Hamid thing was going on, I said, no, I'm not gonna go in on him like that. I'm gonna leave him alone.
This is my same argument for Islam, innit? If you're doing this, yeah, if you're doing certain actions out of your love of your heart for other people, and you're doing it for their best interest, it's not that mentality of when you try to chat to a girl and she rejects you, and then you start cussing her.
Jeez, I don't know about that, G.
But you know that, you know that mentality I'm talking about.
Look at it. I don't know about that. Listen, if a girl don't like me, she must not like men. Come on, G. I'm joking. You're like that, though.
How long has she been gay? I'm saying, though, but if people are doing stuff out of like love and wanting the betterment for their people, the best for individuals, I don't get the mentality of, alright, cool, I'm here to help you. What, you don't want my help? Alright, cool then. Then you start going at them.
Yeah, it's right.
He was right there.
Raj Cam.
Raj had that earlier on.
Raj Cam. But yeah, that kind of mentality of Raj. Alright, cool. Man, hey, what? Hey, Big has got, hey, he's got the camera now.
Dude.
I'm thinking of off the internet.
Yeah, no, I'm thinking about where.
That kind of attitude of, right, cool, I want to help you, oh, you don't want my help, and then attack, it's crazy.
Yeah, but guess what? I'm not attacking him. I refuse to attack him.
He's going to send videos out for him.
No. What I'm doing, remember what I said to you, yeah? I'm not attacking the same. What I'm going to do, he's made like several slander videos, right? What I'm going to do is respond to every single point he made. What I do is scholastic. I respond, I rebuttal points that people make. I deal with information rather than attacking them based upon slander. So I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to challenge. What he did was challenge Mufti Abolaib. He couldn't do it himself personally, hence he put somebody else's video on for like an hour long challenging Mufti Abolaib, right? So I'm going to say, listen, let me challenge some of your teachers. I'm going to challenge Abu Taymiyyah. I'm going to challenge Abdul Rahman Hassan. I'm going to challenge Dawaman. I've already spoken to Dawaman already before I even do it. See them ways there. Because I don't want to be, they call me snake. No, I'm not going to be snaky, bro. I'm going to say, yo, Dawaman, quickly, I want to do a video based upon what he's saying the same. Yo, I'm going to call your name in it, though, as a challenge, right? He's like, yo, I appreciate you doing that to me. I appreciate it because you let me know in advance. I'm like, good, cool, we're nice. So I'm not there to slander man. I'm here to say, yo, I'm going to respond to your claims and I'm going to do exactly what you did. Challenge somebody's teacher and I'm going to challenge your teachers. Because I know I can't learn from you. I can learn from your teachers. Hold on. I listen to their teachers.
Why? You know that's a sneak jab.
It's just the truth.
But it's a sneak.
Okay, it's a sneak jab, but it's the truth.
It's a sneak jab.
It's the truth, though.
Regardless if it's necessary to put that in there?
What?
Like, I can't learn nothing from you. No, like a flipping candle.
Yeah, to be honest with you, I wasn't gonna put that in the video, but you know what? I don't know. You know what, yep. Like in the video, I was gonna be real nice to him. I'm gonna tell the truth, like, because back in the day, I used to watch his videos. I used to be like, yo, you know you're doing good stuff. Like the first conversations, I'm like, yo, I like what you're doing. The whole like you know, like coming from the streets into Islam and all the things there. I'm like, yo, that is hard body. But if you see the videos that he's doing now, it's all like slandering man them. So I'm like, yo, Hussein. I'm like, Hussein, yo, Aki. Back in the day, you was the man, Aki. What happened to you? Now you got the sickest vendetta when it comes to your brothers. You want to play with the brothers? Give me some of my trouble, G. You're going to get my trouble. Straight up and down. You're going to get my trouble. I can't do nothing more but give him my trouble now. And my trouble is straight academic. Oh, man. Yo.
Way too much.
Hey, yo, family, what you saying? You don't want to see what's going on? Let's go. Let's see what Hussein is doing right now. So I'm assuming right now, Hussein is about to do one little video. He's coming over right now, so let's just see.
Move away from me now. Go on, G.
I know you want to get violent right now, I know you want to get violent right now. It's best thing to do is keep your hands in your pocket, G.
Clown.
See, I told you already, right? All they can do is slander me. When I come here, I come to talk like scholastic with people. But all they want to do is slander me.
Okay.
And I told you, I got to be responsible. I've got to be responsible because these men are irresponsible. They man, they got like a good, they man, they got children at home, you know. They man, they got children at home, but yeah, they want to provoke me. And they want to try to intimidate me. You see what I'm saying?
No, no, it's cool, it's cool. I didn't come up to you. I made sure I stayed a distance, right? You saw me, I stayed a distance. I didn't try
don't
to interrupt
me.
That.
Don't
I didn't,
fool
I didn't
me.
Try to interrupt
don't
that,
fool
right?
me. Fool see me. Fool me and see what
so anyway. You see that again?
Fool me.
See that again? Okay. See that again? Go on, carry on, carry on. Listen, I don't even do nothing, G. I stay right here. Yeah, and I just take out the
your
camera.
Uncle Tom,
go on, carry
house
on.
Negro.
Carry on, carry on.
House
carry
house
on. Negro. You got told about this earlier on, right?
Yeah, house Negro.
Go on, carry on, carry on, carry on, carry on. No. Carry on.
Fool me again, I'm gonna knock.
Carry on.
Well, I am gonna knock your finger out of your hand.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
cool.
Can you fool me again, I'm gonna be your finger out.
I mean, there's some fight going on. I'm gonna leave you alone for now because there's fight going on.
Yeah, what's.
I think there's something going on, so I'm gonna leave it the same for now.
KG, what's going on?
No, no, no. And he comes in and makes it worse. No, 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 you're not you, not you, not you, G. Come on. Let's see.
Where's my cameraman? Where was he standing?
That's right, out of the land of the shade, don't I?
Go on, Issa. Tell us what happened now.
This is my point.
Yeah.
That brother, the descendant of Imam Hussein, inshallah he was on the right path, whatever was going on. But I warn you lot, against the Sunni savage monkey beast, be careful with this devil.
Woo.
Study the haq, study both sides of the story. All the traditions, don't let them hide the information, Quran and Ahl al-Bayt.
So what did we just miss, brother? What did we just miss?
I missed it, brother.
Oh,
I
you
came over and they were, you know what I mean, dragging my brother, you know what I mean? But be careful with the Sunni savage monkey beast. Hey. Don't trust it. Don't trust it wherever you are, goddammit.
Hey, who quit it?
Nobody quit it, man. Look at
very intelligent. Yeah, yeah.
This guy.
Yeah.
Are you friends or something, man?
Yep. Yep. Hey, yo, see you. Hey, see you. Hey, yo. I got you earlier on, G. I don't even know, G. So, yeah, man. It's interesting, man. Speaker's Corner is going to get real interesting. Unfortunately, yeah. Unfortunately, I'm going to be real with you.
Do you know what the story is?
No. Do you?
No.
No. Unfortunately, yeah. I'm going to be real with you guys, yeah. Like, we're entering into, yeah, that stage where we're entering into Ramadan, all right? In the next few days, yeah, we're going to be entering into Ramadan. And this is my prophecy slash prediction. You're going to see a lot more violence, yeah, at Speaker's Corner, all right? I'm not saying it's going to be a lot of violence coming from Shia Muslims. We ain't saying that, right? We're only going to tell you that these... What's good, my brother? Good, good. I love my brother, love my brother. You're not on there. Yo, my brother. Jeez! You're there, yeah?
Big up Titan TV.
All day. So again, yeah, you're not going to find this, yeah?
Is there any from the recent visit from Brother, Anthony Brother?
I don't know if he's coming down. I'll tell you who's coming down though. Professor James Smalls.
Okay.
Yeah, so at the end of the month he's coming down. Cool. Bye, brother.
Hey. How can you guys come back all these people, man? It's like talking to a wall.
No, it's no point.
It's hard work and difficult respect, man.
There's no point.
There's
some of them are
lost.
Exactly.
You know?
Give me 1 minute, I'll be back, yeah? Alright. So again, yeah, I'm gonna say this, yeah. You're not gonna see a lot of these violent attacks, yeah, coming from Shia Muslims, all right? You're gonna see most of these attacks here, not even coming from the majority of Sunni Muslims. It's gonna come from the one sect, okay? Only one sect, okay, is gonna continue with this madness, yeah? And it's gonna be from the sect of the Wahhabis. These are the only individuals here that carry on with these types of madness, yeah? And in specific, yeah, I'll tell you, those, yeah, who are under Qutubism, most of them don't even know that they're underneath these types of ideologies. Most of them don't even understand that they're Wahhabis. Most of them just think that they're Muslims, right? That's what they think. Until they come to understand, yeah, that their mosques has been taken over. Their mosques have been taken over by the Wahhabi sect. And this Wahhabi sect in particular, yeah, creates violence. It thrives on violence. It thrives on intimidation. It thrives on violence and domination. That's what it does. And that's me being real. So just clock it, right?
every single year, when it comes to Ramadan, yeah, you see the most amount of violence, terrorist attacks. Pre it. All over the world, you're gonna see it. France, US, Australia, Europe, everywhere, you're gonna see it. And I'm just being real with you. And you will think that this one month, where it's the most holiest month of them all, yeah, you will not see this type of violence. Right? That's what you think. Lah, no. This is the month that you're gonna see the most amount of violence, simply because they think they're doing the works of their God. That's what they believe. Unbeknownst to them, they're doing the works of the antithesis of what God is supposed to be. That's why I called most of these individuals, yeah, Abdul Tagut. Yeah? They're the slaves of transgression. Absolute Abduls. They have no understanding yet of their own religion, bro. That's why I tell you, I don't have no problem against Islam, you know. There ain't not. I'm going to say again, you see, a lot of you are going to get upset with me for saying this. There is absolutely nothing wrong with Islam. There's absolutely nothing wrong with Islam. There's absolutely nothing wrong with the Quran. 100%. There's nothing wrong with Islam. There's nothing wrong with the Quran. All it is a concept. All it is words on a piece of book, on a book. Right? Words on paper. Ink on paper. That's what it is. But it's these individuals, yeah, that have some corrupted, mad, abomination of a heart, yeah? Woo! Blaps! Yeah, mad corruption inside of their soul, yeah? They use these books, yeah? I'm telling you, they would even use, if they had the opportunity to, yeah? They would use Harry Potter. If they could create a cult out of Harry Potter, yeah? They would. They could create a cult out of Harry Potter. They could and they would. Yeah? That's why I don't blame the religion. I don't blame the Quran for all of this. I blame the people that pick up these books that have these evil corrupted hearts and the way that they interpret it and believe that they could go ahead and do the most amount of madness on road. You already seen Hussein, right? Out of a moment's notice, yeah, he will tell you, oh, the Quran doesn't teach us this. Oh, this doesn't do this. But I guarantee you, he will find a justification somewhere. Yes, I'm live. I'm live, baby. Talk to me.
Live chat and shit.
Yep, over 420 people here.
Kalem, Kalem, you're so intelligent. You're a lion of Kemet, a lion of free speech.
But you know what though, yeah? Kalem, stop winding my man up, bro. Because you better put the camera in his face. Don't wind him up, bro. Because we're trying to...
He lied to you if he told you that. He lied to you if he told you that.
It's a good thing I'm Muslim.
He lied to you if he told you that. I didn't do that. 100%.
It's a good thing.
I was at mad distance. I was over here talking, bro.
It's a good thing I'm Muslim.
He got wild, he got triggered.
Go ahead.
No, do you know what? He's saying I'm violent and this and the other. I already stopped a fight between a Sikh and a Muslim. You know? I'm always fighting for Islam. But it's a good thing I'm a Muslim. It's a good thing I'm Muslim because everyone's Muslim. Look how many times things have popped up. I've never had a fight with anyone in this park. But it's a good thing I am a Muslim because I would have knocked the hell out of you.
Tell me again.
It's a good thing. So, alhamdulillah, you're saying I'm violent, but it's a good thing I'm a Muslim because the amount of times that sorry come up to me, you come up to me,
Wait, pause, one second.
Because of my religion, I'm not going to box you in the face.
Because of my religion?
Yeah.
Alright. Now, we all know that's false, right? Sorry. Go on. Say again. Sorry. I believe in freedom of speech.
He's trying to capture you, man. Don't say don't. So basically, yeah, there's a scenario where it feels like there's an antagonistic energy, yeah, going both ways, but he's trying to stay calm, and he feels like you putting the camera in his face or filming him over there was like an antagonistic move. So now he's saying he's lucky that he's got Islam as his anchor to keep him grounded, otherwise he would have reacted angrily and given way to his passions.
You believe that?
And do I believe that? Yeah, because he's never struck you.
He's never struck me.
He didn't. Has he struck you before?
He's never struck me.
No,
I never shot you. That time that you had the little.
Yeah,
I never shot him.
No, no, of course not.
Yeah. No, it was a strike to him.
No, of course not.
Because I pushed his arm away.
No, of course not. Of course not. Did he push a woman or push somebody away?
I never pushed anyone.
You remember seeing it?
I never pushed her.
Go back and watch the video.
Go back and watch
the video.
Go back and watch the video.
Oh, what? Empress P.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, man.
Yeah, but we were in the heat of a fight, man. What did you shove him?
He's saying yes.
Did you shove her? Just get off me.
I don't know, G. Go on.
You saying, man? Come on.
You said you saw, right? You said you saw.
I pushed with me.
Explain to me. Are you talking? Was there a time when Empress Pete was trying to come
there, was a few people he literally like bulldozed.
Yeah, but
out
like,
of
like, and then
so I don't know, right?
To me,
Hussein is a bit violent. And I don't think Islam stops him from being violent.
He's not been violent though.
I stopped the most fights.
Everybody watching right now, saw him threaten me.
Threaten you, but he's not being violent, bro. Stop that, man.
Come on,
no, he's
come on. Come on, G. Come on, G. Come on, G.
Come on, G. That's why he talks like that.
You can't be, bro. Come on, bro. Because you grow up with the man them.
Yeah. Like, he didn't grow up with the man them. That's why
he did. No, he never. I know Kalam. I know what school went to. I know who he grew up with. He grew up with the man them. Yeah, but this is the thing. Alright, cool. That's a personal thing, but what I'm saying is you're aware, you know that certain men have different ways of expressing themselves. Don't take advantage of it because you feel like you're in a better place, or you can be calmer, or you're more,
Muslim,
or you're
I'm
more
detached. Box him up. That's why.
Or
he
you're
knows
more
he
detached from
pushing it.
But like, come on, fam. Bro, like at the end of the day, dogs out here should be safe and cool to be in a public, but we don't antagonize them. Not calling him a dog or liking him to a dog, but we don't antagonize things, because there's such a thing as provocation.
Okay.
Now, what you deem as provocation and what another man deems provocation is different. So if he feels that his personal space and he just wants to just kind of be left alone by you and whatever, then I think you should kind of respect that. I know it's speaker's corner, but if you feel him from over there, knowing that the history you don't have,
to me,
it can be an antagonistic move. All right, that's all I'm going to say.
Okay. Huh? So I already, on this video, I said, the reason why I'm not going to try to have no dialogue with him is because I know he cannot control himself.
Okay.
And I fully well know he's not responsible enough. He's very irresponsible.
Okay.
And I think I don't think about myself. I think about himself and I think about his family and his children. Right? So I don't want to antagonize him, because he may end up in a police cell or prison cell. And I may because of me, I would have taken away a father from their daughter from his daughter.
Would you press charges?
Do you see what I'm saying? I'm not saying I'll press charges.
I would press charges. So he could bang you could have a straight now.
Huh?
I'm not saying that because this is about this about
Speaker's corner.
It's not for straighteners. I get
it's not for that.
I know that.
No. Hold on. On a dark alley. On a dark alley.
You're not gonna do nothing.
You're
camp. You're feminine.
Bro, you're an intelligent being. You let him trigger you.
I'm not gonna hit him. He knows because I'm a Muslim. I can't hit him. That's why he keeps pushing it.
So anyways,
by that time when you come
saying,
to Tara,
in a dark
and then
alley,
he backfired,
and somebody,
he's going to go
put in the bin.
You're going to do nothing.
Like, come on now.
If
it was in a dark alley,
you're not going to do nothing.
Somebody was coming up to me,
you're
and putting
stars.
Themselves
you're
in my face or whatever. It'd be the
wrong
situation, right?
You're little camp stars, man.
Come on.
Your little Jay-Z bloody...
So anyways, that's the reason. This is the reason why I'm all the way over here. Far away.
I hear that.
Far away. Wait, stop. My brother could testify right now, unless he's going to try to protect his brother, I did not come up to him right here.
Tell the truth. Come up to me. Let me be honest with you. He was over there filming. And he was talking about me.
Did he come close to
you? And he came close.
Okay, cool.
And he
so I was mad for. Man came up to me. I don't need to lie. It's all on camera. I can't lie on my own camera now, G.
Anyway, either way.
So yeah.
As intellectual men, I'm proud fathers, Your father yourself, right? So if I'm putting you on the spot,
I really
whatever,
want to just knock him out.
But this is the thing.
But I won't, because his love tells me not to.
There's plenty of people I would like to knock out.
He's not violent.
One second. Bro, let's be real, innit?
Go ahead.
Life is violent. Society is violent. Our government are violent.
Go ahead.
Nature is violent.
Mm.
You feel what I'm trying to say? Nature is violent.
I'm with you.
Are you a part of nature?
Yeah.
Exactly. So violence has its place.
That's right.
What place does violence have? What is this place? Where is violence acceptable?
In self-defense, B.
Only in self-defense?
It could be other places as well, but...
Where?
I'm saying right now, self-defense is my main topic.
Okay, cool. But there's other ways. There's other places violence could be. That's what you're saying. Yeah, there's other places. So what I'm saying is the line here of a man's I don't know what you want to call it, manhood, dignity, whatever, his tolerance level, yeah. Is to a degree where you feel that you can mock it and laugh it and prod at him. And I commend you for doing the puppet master thing with him, yeah?
Yeah.
However though, if it backfires, bro,
like Sarah, right?
if it does backfire,
bring the team,
don't just. You're gonna have to be honest and say, you know, I've been poking him.
Of course.
Like, right now, you know you're poking him.
100.
You know if it was in the hood.
I'll tell you right now.
Yeah, you know
what? 100%
end up in the grass.
Yeah,
but why are you? Why
in the hood? I won't be poking him. Of course not.
Because it's feminine. You won't be poking him.
Bro, so
then let's say you need to.
You know why?
Hold on. What makes men different? From the people here. That's what people here do. Yeah. They get brave.
Yeah.
They get brave. One second. They get brave when they feel like there's a scenario that protects them.
Yeah.
Yeah. But. This is the thing, on road it's a very different thing.
I'm scared of something here.
You are scared.
So anyways, Hussein just tried to grab the camera out of my hand, right? Everybody here is witnessing it, yeah? Alright, cool. Anyway, continue.
Bro.
I thought it was a joke, to be honest.
Bro, I'm not gonna lie to you. The circus thing is all fun and jokes.
Uh-huh.
Like, for everyone, it's all good. Everyone's enjoying the circus thing and that. But this thing here is gonna get to a point where there's gonna be something that's gonna happen and no one's gonna be able to take it back. Yeah, and we're all responsible, yeah?
That's right.
So if he bangs you or does whatever he does to you, bro, check this. And you know you're provoking him,
even
though his response may not be warranted. The feds are right there, fam, yeah? Uh-huh. The feds are right there, just reminding you,
man.
Yeah?
Come on, man.
Yeah? See them there?
Right there. Behind that.
Again, right?
This is crazy.
No, because you're provoking him. That's what I'm saying.
Did you see that? The camera hasn't been in his face. Again, second time. Second time.
Because this is going to turn silly.
Again, for real. Again, it'll be very irresponsible, of me, yeah? Oh, get out of here, man. It'll be very irresponsible of me, yeah, to continue, yeah, right now. Why am I saying this, yeah? Why am I saying it'd be responsible for me? Because clearly, Hussein is very triggered. And I already said before, I do not want to take away, a father from his daughters, or father from his children, a father from his wife, or husband from their wife. I wouldn't want to do it, right? Right? And I ain't going to lie to you, yeah? Clearly, I'm here, yeah? And I know my very presence, yeah, is very antagonizing to a lot of people. I don't even have to open up my mouth. All I have to do, yeah, is stand here, move the camera, and smile. And I 100% know, yeah, everybody's wild up by me. But I'm ready, regardless of the situation. You already know me, I ain't backing down shit. Anyway, family. Let me hear my Jedi speak real quickly.
One of the things about...
We're going to close it down.
Going on from school ground days, I realized, yeah, even if you genuinely want to calm me down, yeah, the worst thing to do is for you all to rush me. Calm down. Yeah. Leave it. All that sensation and that, yeah.
It makes it
slows down the ability for the brain to rationalize, and then you're gonna do something knee-jerk.
Yeah.
Eyes and loads of eyes just provokes egotistical kind of response, isn't it? Yeah. Not saying he's egotistical, but with everyone watching, like it will make you feel away. Callum, exercise. Restraint, brother, yeah?
Uh-huh.
Like, if you know what you can do and you know how you can do it, don't do it. That's what makes me rate you.
Mm.
Yeah, like, we know what we could do. We're arguing. You know I could do that, innit? But I'm not going to. So even if we're arguing, you're still going to respect a certain part of me, bro. Like, if you know, come on, fam. If you got a different countenance to him and you understand or you've overstood his countenance and you know that it's one that you can... discombobulate.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe just keep it moving from him, and then it's done, and then you're good. You go back to your you. I saw it was your youth's birthday. Happy birthday, Callum Junior. And he's got his ones, and he's got his life, and let's just keep it moving. Because at the end of the day, fam, it's a nice day, and we're here just to exchange ideas. If you can't exchange ideas with each other peacefully, then exchange ideas with me or someone else, or rare, and let him do his thing. What he felt away was after that initial exchange, you went on to carry on. Sorry, family. Carry on talking about him.
Yeah.
And he didn't like that. Wrap it. Let's wrap it, man.
Oh man. You see what? My brother Jedi here just gave some wise words right there. I'm about on 1% right now, yeah, so I need to shut it down. You guys, my pen is running out. If you don't love it so far, yeah, and you love what I do at Speaker's Corner, and I go in, you know I go in for you guys, right? I get it in. I'm walking away right now, yeah? Yeah, yeah, I know. I told you already, my very presence is antagonizing to a lot of you Muslims. Trust me on that. So, you already know, man, how I do this. I really do this strong. I do this strong. And what I gotta do is smile to people, and they just worked up. Yeah? Worked up. All I gotta do is ask some questions, and they get worked up. All I gotta do is present some information, and they get worked up. And they want to tell me that they're peaceful. That's the most funniest ish I've heard all day. But anyways, family, love. I'm going to catch you guys a little bit later on. And you already know I'm going to try to poke a few more beers in Speaker's Corner, yeah? I've already gotten that Ali Dow. I've already gotten that Muhammad Hijab. And then Hussein was the next on the hit list. And I ain't finished on Hussein yet, to be honest with you. Is that real? He can't be sending no, bruv, I love my brothers. I got to be real with you, yeah? You can't be sending shots at me and my brothers constantly, yeah? And don't expect me to come back at you. I'm going to tear that ass up.